What's up, guys? This is Coop from Garage Gym Reviews. Welcome to the new Garage Gym. We have much more content to show in here in the future, but today we are reviewing these bad boys. These are the Rep ISO Arms from Rep Fitness, and they are, in my opinion, a direct competitor to the Rogue Fitness LT1 50 cal, that's a long name, trolley system, and the Sorinex adjustable jammer arms. Now, the question that you're all asking from the very start, and I'll help you right here from the very beginning, is are these compatible with other racks besides the Rep PR5000? And my answer is yes. They should be compatible with every rack, every 3x3 rack that's out there. Rep actually uses smaller holes and smaller hardware than Rogue does and Sorinex does, so they should fit across. I tried them on different uprights. They fit just fine. These are actually Titan uprights, which I believe use a similar, pretty much the exact same hole and size and pattern as the Rep PR5000. It works on this, it works on Rogue and Sorinex. So if you're wondering, do these work on every rack? Yes, they do. Now into the actual, like, my opinion on them. The design of these is very much an adjustable arm. It's supposed to go up and down. The big difference that we're gonna see on these versus Sorinex or Rogue is this doesn't have a necessarily dedicated trolley system. And what I mean by that, Rogue and Sorinex are both using a system that uses rollers on the back and the front. And then there's a lockdown method to like keep it up against. So Rogue has those nice stainless steel arms. Sorinex is different from that. Sorinex uses a lever system. I've got those at the gym. But this one has no such thing. And that's one reason they're able to lower the cost, has a lot fewer parts. So the way that this adjusts is you pull these pins out, one there, one here, and then it goes up and down just using the handle. So it's basically permanently against the rack. However tight it's going to be, you aren't able to adjust that at all. But they're using UHMW plastic that's actually rather smooth to allow you to go up and down on the rack. So here's what I'll say on that. One, as you can see, this thing is not super light. I think with the handle, it's around 65 pounds. So for most people, when you're adjusting this, I'd recommend taking the handle assembly off because it's gonna add some weight. However, like, is it that much lighter or that much heavier than other ones that are out there? The Rogue one is by far the seamless and most easy to use to adjust up and down. Sorinex, in my opinion, is even more difficult than this because you've got this lever that constantly comes down. I've had it hit my head multiple times. It's just awkward and annoying. But I would say this one is between those. This one is not as easy to move as Rogue. It's, I think, easier than Sorinex. However, it does have a little bit more play than the Sorinex version. So Rogue, because they're able to push it up against really tight, Sorinex, because they're able to push it up against really tight and it's adjustable, the adjustment is just vertical. You don't have any side to side or forward and backward play. It did allow them to put it pretty tight up against the upright, like the side to side this way movement is not a ton. You can see there's a little bit, but there is a little bit more this way. Now, what I'll say is it much more than Rogue or Sorinex? No, it's really not. It's actually pretty good. It's not something that I think is a deal breaker. So honestly, the overall design of this is pretty good. And the reason that it's pretty good is because it's $399. All right, so this system, which is going to be able to do pretty much all the things that you can do with the Rogue or Sorinex version, is less than half the cost. And it actually has some additional features that make it more functional. However, it must be understood that the reason it's half the cost, partially the reason, is because it's made overseas. Now, you decide if that's something that you want to pay for, something to be made in the US or not, but because they're able to make it overseas and get them cheaper, they can sell it to the customer for cheaper. So the quality on this is not at the level of a Rogue or Sorinex. The powder coating isn't as good, the knurling isn't as good. That's not to say it's bad. This is certainly better than most, like, it's better than Titan stuff, but I still don't think it's quite at the level of Rogue. But they've thought of some great features. One is they've decided to knurl the entire handle assembly. There is like this little knurl pattern. It would have been nice if they extended it farther, but it's better than nothing. And this is something that Rogue and Sorinex both leave off their handle assembly. There's no knurling whatsoever. Then the other thing is they're also using a chrome tube here. So Rogue's using stainless steel. It's not gonna corrode, but it's also gonna look good over time, whereas Sornex is using powder coat that ends up chipping. This chrome is actually a good option. It's cheaper than stainless steel. It is going to corrode over time, but not crazy bad, but it's not gonna mar and scratch and get crappy over time like something like powder coat. They're also got some other things like they've thought through. They're using like these end caps here that are just like finer details, rubber grips on the back, easy to change out hitch pins here, which are the same they use on the Rep Belt Squat. And they're using like this nice stainless cut logo with their new like mountain logo that we've seen a lot on a lot of the new stuff they're doing. Now that's kind of like some of the just aesthetics of the machine, but the functionality that I think kind of brings this, separates it a little bit from Rogue and Sornex. And you know, they released this a year or two after both Sornex and Rogue did. So they've been able to see one, all the reviews that we've done and provided like improvements on things they should do. Two, they're able to see what the community thinks. And three, they're just able to think of like different things they can do. So they're able to take what Rogue and Sornex have done and maybe improve upon it in some ways. So one of the ways that they're able to do that, you guys have probably all seen the J-Squat from Sornex. They've included standard that can stay on here permanently, an eye hook that you can attach a belt squat hook to. So you attach your belt squat to it, you're then able to use it as a belt squat. The difference is there's no like kickstand like comes on the Sornex J squat. The other feature that I think is really the big one and the one that most people should think about, and that is adjust the height of it. So you can put this hitch pin in here that then locks into the arm, and now these are fixed. So you can use these for pull-ups. If you bring them down lower, you can use these for dips. Or you can also use them for triphasic training. This is something that no other lever arm system can be used for in that manner. So all that to like sum up and say, are these as good as Rogue and Sornex? In some ways, no. But in some ways, yes, and they're even better. So in some ways, I prefer this because I like the eye bolt on here for belt squats. I probably won't use it because I have a dedicated cable system and lever arm belt squats aren't that great. But for most home gym owners, having a piece that can do multiple things, awesome. The other thing, I do like this feature. Now you can use these for dips and pull-ups, and that's something you can't do with the other. And then the third one, the biggest reason why I like these for most home gym owners is the price, $400. The Rogue ones are $995, Sornex's are $999. They do have a more robust, better system, but for most people, do they need that better system and that better quality, the better welds, better powder coat, all that stuff? No, that's more aesthetic. So if that's the thing that you're going for, which I prefer that sort of thing, then I'll go for that. But if you just want pure functionality and value for the price, these are, in my opinion, the best value jam arms that are out there. They're laser cut on the sides with, they got holes all the way up and down, laser cut numbers like I asked for previously. You know, the handles assembly is nice, easy to adjust up and down. Now, here's one thing that I don't know why they didn't add this in. I feel like it wouldn't be that hard, but they've got this pin here that only allows you to use it on these two holes. And I noticed if you bring this down, if they took a piece of metal and made it longer and made it all the way around, they could then put holes all the way around, laser cut numbers on there, and then you could fix the arm at any distance on this piece. I don't think that would add a crazy amount of expense. I'm not sure why they didn't do it, but that's something I feel like they should have done. And then the other thing I wish they would have done is I wish they would have allowed us another hole maybe below, so then you could prop this arm at different heights for starting points. So if you're saying doing overhead press, so instead of having to like clean it and then press it, you could start with it out, which I've seen something by a guy named Gavin Laird, Gavin Laird Strength on Instagram. He's done that for a company, I think Primal Strength over in the UK. But that's an idea that they could add to this. But beyond that, I think it's pretty darn good. $400. I wasn't a huge fan of the Rep Belt Squat. There's a lot of things that I think need to be done with it. Some corners they cut. But this, for most people, if you want jammer arms, this is your best bet for cost. They're sweet. All right, it's Coop from Garage Gym Reviews. Thanks for watching. What do you think of them? Let me know in the comments. See you next time. Peace.